Pastor Robert Kayanja of Rubaga Miracle Center Cathedral in Kampala led a team of pastors and arrived in Juba at the invitation of Pentecostal churches to preach at the ongoing Juba Mega Miracle Crusade. Kayanja said South Sudan is a great country with great people with great history, and he hopes it will change and rise again.
Understand that Sudan is a baby. She's just beginning to walk, and she was not given a chance because of so many factors that were playing. But thank be to God, now Sudan is much more better. I think they have learned, I think they have come to realize that no matter how different you are, we are all brothers and sisters, and we are Africans. And especially now they are part of East Africa, it makes it more difficult for them to just solve their problem by their own, because now they are brothers and sisters, and we need South Sudan in East Africa. We create a bigger block in order to develop. The market is bigger, the people bigger, and the love and relationship is bigger. So we pray that they need to continue stick themselves together as we chant forward together.
Pastor Kayanja traveled to South Sudan to deliver spiritual guidance at a crusade considered as one of the global services organized by Midan Simba Giada Jebel near Juba University, as explained.
It's a story of recovery, it's a story of power, and a story of joy. And we are glad to be part of what God is doing. But also, yesterday we kicked off a great crusade, and we are going to have another one tonight and tomorrow. We are ministering to government officials, we are ministering to prayer breakfasts and businesses, and it's going to be a great power-packed meeting. And I believe by the time we finish and go back to Uganda, the Lord would have done a greater, mighty things. In His name, glory to His name.
According to Kayanja, with God's grace, South Sudan will be great again. Kayanja was excited to physically serve food to the children, both school-going and the street children, and homeless ones as well, after speaking to them at church. He also toured a few food processing factories near the church and said he was excited to see that the country can now process food for its own people.
We see the factory, the equipment they are bringing in. That tells you what? That tells you that the church needs to wake up all over Africa. This is a new level of the Pentecostal church, the way they are handling situations. Because always they used to pray for issues. Now we don't only need to pray for issues, we need to get involved in the economics. And we saw it yesterday. Factory after factory after factory after factory. And the amazing thing is, they have taken one bin of maize and they have created four products out of it. The Ugandan maize, they have created four. It's a lesson to me. So I'm going to go back to the drawing board and learn from our brothers.
Pastor Kayanja also highlighted in his recently finished book on the imbalances of Africa's 400 years of bondage, slavery, stagnation and poverty, plus confusion. Kayanja believes that the mission is set out for all South Sudan citizens, regardless of religion, creed, belief or tribe.